So hello guys, before you watch this video, it's probably a good idea just pay a bit attention to what I'm going to say now, because it's a very long video. Why is that? Well, it is because I would really like to explain you guys why it took me such an amount of time to come back on YouTube with a new video. The whole idea now is to make a new game and make a company and then promote Little Big Adventure Remake. But for all the details, please stay and watch, because it could be really interesting, I think. And I would also like to know what you think about it in the comments, etc. So please try to watch it all. Okay, thanks. Hello guys, how are you doing? Moritz here. My real name is actually Maurice. So in a couple 6 months, I had a lot of things on my mind, especially music. Since I am a musician, I am a pianist. I'm also taking singing lessons now for 2 years to do something with that as well. I must say that the first 3 months after the latest work in progress, I worked a lot on the Little Big Adventure remake. But then I thought, well, you know, I worked 3 months even after the last upload very hard to get a lot of things done. But it was actually a bit too much. Also because finally my concerts were finally happening again, because I could not play for almost 2 years, not one concert, because of the whole situation with Corona. And it is still really, really bad, but I did follow singing lessons. I did make recordings with my great bassist Theotin Voisin, and then the great news came that Little Big Adventure 3 is going to take place. So with that news, I was also a bit relieved, because my intention actually was to produce a remake to get the attention again on the game, on the Big Adventure. We all love this amazing game, and at that moment it seemed as if it was forgotten, and that was my whole idea, was to bring the game again to life through a remake. I also had a pretty long conversation with DJ Sean Frey, so one of the makers of Little Big Adventure. I cannot say a lot about this conversation, but what I can say is that there was something going on with the rights, so it would be really difficult to actually give me anything of the rights at that stage, but he said that they were working on something. So, and now we all know that what they were working on was Little Big Adventure 3. So, and he said to me that, well, he looked to my videos, so the things I uploaded, because they were searching for IDs for a new game. Let me be clear, I don't want to take any credit or something, so I just did it because I think it is a very important game in history, and it is very sad, it was very sad that it seemed to be forgotten. But so when I heard the news, Little Big Adventure 3, I started 1 year ago, or what was it? Maybe 1.5 years ago. I started already 3 years ago with the idea to probably work on a remake. But like 1 year and maybe 4 months later, after I worked on the remake, I heard the news of Little Big Adventure 3, and my first thought was, wow, that's amazing, because that's why I was doing it. So I was not doing it to just to make a remake, and because I also knew that would probably be difficult, you know, because of the whole rights situation, and you know, I don't have an own company or anything at this stage, so you're going to get into sort of trouble. But when I heard this news, I thought, well, that's what I did it for. I didn't do it to make a new Little Big Adventure game in the first place. I did it really to get the attention of people and to say, well, guys, don't forget that this was one of the most interesting, beautiful games out there in history. And and also Greg, of course, it was already working on his remake or his Little Big Adventure game for over 10 years. So I think we and also other people that are also making remakes, or for example the makers from the Little Big Adventure 2 remake or remastered, I have to say, because it's not a remake, but it's a remastered version, I guess. That's the way to call it. We tried to put the attention on the game, and I think we all succeeded in that. Or at least we helped a bit, I think. And that's amazing. So then I thought, well, what can I do? You know, they're working on Little Big Adventure 3. So probably the situation for me to make a Little Big Adventure remake is going to be even more tedious, since I don't, again, I don't have a company, so I cannot negotiate about rights. So I thought, I don't want to quit what I begun. So what I maybe can do is the next thing is, I was already for some years ago developing an own game, and so the things I'm going to show you in this video are first the things you still didn't see, so the new islands and new houses, etc., that I made for the Little Big Adventure remake. But the second thing I want to show you is the game that my brother and me want to make ourselves, and also to take that a bit more serious in terms of business. So we really want to start an own company, and when we then when we work on our game, we also want to negotiate again with the makers of Little Big Adventure, and I'm not sure that's going to succeed. But at least we are a bit back on track then, and we can actually start making a game without any rights issue. And if we are a company, well, we have something to talk about. So that's the thing. And so 3 years ago, I started actually 6 years ago making this game. I tried to develop a point-and-click adventure game, which I love. I really love the genre. I think it's an amazing genre, also a bit forgotten genre. And so, but now with this whole remake Little Big Adventure history, I actually would like to change the game a bit. So I would like to make it, because it is now, well, 2.5D, I would call it. So it's with pre-rendered backgrounds, or actually it's with a camera mapping. If you don't understand the concepts, you can search it on Google. It's very familiar concept. So you project textures, pre-rendered textures on models from a certain camera angle, and the characters are all in 3D. So I already started that, but I think I want to take that to the next level, and I want to sort of combine the style of Little Big Adventure, not completely because that's not going to work, but to make a sort of Grim Fandango game of that. So it will still be very much like a point and click adventure, only the difference will be that it will be tank controlled, so you will really control the character, not with the mouse, but with the way ASD keys or with a controller. And you will also sometimes you sometimes have to fight enemies. I'm not going to really talk about specifics yet, but in the future I will, of course. And so it will, like, it will actually be a sort of Little Big Adventure in Grim Fandango style. It's a bit, maybe it sounds a bit strange, but I think it will really work. And we probably want to make that in Unreal Engine. Why? Because, well, I checked Unreal Engine and, you know, there are some things really, in terms of stability, which was always a problem for me in Unity too, because things change all the time. And that's also the reason that we used an older Unity version from 2018. Because every time you have to change it, you have to change all the code, all the things, you name it, you know, it's just, it gets very tedious and time consuming, you know. And so I think that will also help. And we, of course, then want also to start a sort of Kickstarter campaign, and we would like to ask you for some money, you know, so we can also really make the company, also invite other people to the company. I still am not sure how that all works, but I'm pretty sure about this idea. I'm just still studying Unreal Engine a bit myself at this stage, and I'm also in my mind working on the ideas and also draw them on paper and write the story, of course, of the game. However, for a big part, this was already thought out by myself. So that's actually the stage where we are in right now. A lot of things happened also in my life. I live now in a new house also since you know, since July, but also some very good friend of me was in the hospital, and a lot of things were going on in my life. So and a part of that, I also had to play concerts, so with, on the piano, and I just had not so much time. So sorry for that, guys, but that's just how it is. And apart from that, we need to be realistic and just, yeah, need a company first. So first we're going to watch the Little Big Adventure remake, but I must also say something that I almost forgot to say, and that is that I also, a part of my own busy things all the time, I had also the problem that my laptop's fan, something is wrong with the fan, or something is going on, something is stuck, and we cannot find out what it actually is. I contacted Dell already for a few months ago. They wanted me to install a lot of things and etc., but yeah, of course it didn't work because it's a hardware problem. So if everything goes all right, then in a few days someone will come here to check my laptop, and then I hope that it will fix the problem, because it also gives me laggy results. Like, I can record stuff, but yeah, you see it's lagging, you know, so that's a pity. But yeah, you know, I can wait and wait and wait, but I thought, no, I'm going to just upload this video now or these days, because otherwise, you know, it takes just too long, all the problems and busyness altogether. So I hope you can still enjoy it. And I must add one last thing. Sometimes I see people talk about this remake as if it is a finished product already, and it really isn't. So also for the things that we made, or that I made the last months, the last 6 months or last year, that we worked on it are not finished by any means. Some islands, in my opinion, are almost finished, like the Citadel Island. You know, it looks, it's far from perfect, but the whole basic idea is there, I think. And then some people are also complaining about that the color should be blue or something. I think, my God, we're living in 2021, and you know, if we make a game, then this game has always a sunset or a sunrise, and you know, the weather is dynamic. So of course you will, at a certain point or moment, you will see that the sky is blue and that it reflects on the objects and etc., etc. But it will always be dynamic, of course. So that's the whole point of making a remake, you know, is making, using the things that we can use nowadays to show how the game will look nowadays. So that's just what I would like to add. Okay, and now we're going to enjoy the Little Big Adventure remake. So basically what you see here is the library in Principal Island. As you can see, it's far from finished, but at least you can already see some details like the books, etc. And you can even walk downstairs. You can see we have here a little small opening that leads into this Book of Boo part of the library, and yeah, so that's actually that's all there is to say. So here we have the White Leaf Desert. I was really very much inspired with the trees and the ground and the colors, and you name it. As you can see, I only sort of finished the first part of Desert Island. But it is not completely finished by any means, so it's still missing post effects and a lot of color effects. Lots of details, you name it. But I think it gives already some an impression of what it could be. So here we have Principal Island. This was a lot of work, I must say, but it is, as you can see, far from finished. But at least I was able to lay out the map a bit. So here you see the village, the small village on Principal Island. And the next thing I will show you is this part of Principal Island, the military part. I was able to design all the houses, model them, as you can see. So here we have the library, a bit small, and here we have a part that I forgot the name of at this moment. And these are the ruins. And I tried out different lighting, as you can see here. It's always interesting to see the difference in atmosphere. So, and here you can see Dr. Von Bruck's building a bit. This is the Temple of Boo. Also far from finished, I'm afraid. But at least it gives you some impression of what I was working on. These are the Himalayan mountains. I worked very long to get the snow tracks working.
and create a little Big Adventure logo in the snow. Okay, so now it's time to talk about Colwalkie. So the game we were already developing, or actually I was developing on my own. So here it is. I will show it to you. So as you can see, it starts with pretty mysterious music that I improvised myself, by the way. And in short, the story is about two brothers. One disappears out of the blue and no one knows what happened to him. The whole game starts at a fictive island near Plymouth, and well, the whole goal of the game is to find your brother. We have the suspicion that an evil spirit is taking over, and so that's the mystery part also about it. And well, I guess let's not spoil too much. So this is the part where you can see the two brothers walking next to each other. Of course, with the technique that I had available in this time, it was really hard to retarget the characters, as you can also see a bit. But I think in the end, I succeeded in making a movie. Of course, I don't show you everything, but just a few parts. Well, I think one could argue that. And that is indeed strange. Yeah, at a certain moment the game starts. So it's a true point and click adventure game, as you can see here. No, it can't be. And well, I would say have a look for a while. Place of missing point anyway.
Not that I'm hungry right now.
So all the pre-rendered backgrounds you see here were actually the first backgrounds I made, and after a while, I upgraded the graphics. Why are you sorry? As you can see, very soon. This is in the small house you just saw.
Great. Now I can.
What?
So here you have a map. And this is the updated version. So now you can see that, well, after a year of working or so, I updated the graphics. So now you have a camera that is really moving towards the character. And so this is what I was talking about. This is a this is also called projection mapping. So here you have the same tractor scene, but in 3D. Basically it's 3D, but with projected textures. So yeah, that's about it. So I share here now a few screenshots of what I made, or actually pictures, things that I made in Photoshop. Also I tried out different lighting, as you can see here.
And yeah, so I'm looking very much forward to make this game in true 3D in Unreal Engine. And yeah, that's actually the whole goal. So the whole goal is really to, well, I will first say to you guys that the idea is to release the first demo that I finished back then. So that's a demo from 2015, 2016, something like that. So that will be not with the updated graphics, unfortunately, but it gives you already an ID, and also it learns you a bit what the story is about and what is happening inside the game. But the end goal is to really, yeah, really make it so that it is that all the game objects will be imported into Unreal Engine, and then we will make a 3D game of it in a 2.5D style, where you can really walk with the character with tank controls or with a controller, and then you will also have some fights. So it will not be a true point and click adventure game anymore, but a true 3D game in the end. So that's the idea. So I really hope that you enjoyed this new information. Of course, I will make a website, and I will indeed try to start as soon as possible a Kickstarter campaign. Please subscribe if you would like to help us. Give a like to the video. You know, that are all kinds of things that help us. And please write in the comments what you think about this ID or the different IDs. And because that would also help me a bit, help us a bit in the end. Well, I think that's about it. So I wish you all a very great day. And see you soon.